Once upon a mountaintop near Bethlehem, three young trees were planted. The seasons and the years rolled by, and as they grew, they dreamed of what they wanted to be when they were big and strong.
When I look up at the twinkling stars, I dream of treasure. I hope I'll be turned into a beautiful treasure chest. I want to be filled with gold, silver, precious stones, and exotic perfumes. I will be the most beautiful treasure chest in the whole world.
When I look down on that river flowing out into the mighty sea, I want to be made into the most powerful ships sailing the high seas, carrying important people across the world, maybe a royal ship fit for a king.
I love this hill so much that I don't want to leave it at all. I just want to stay here on this beautiful mountain and grow into the tallest tree ever, so that when people look up to me, they will be looking up to God and heaven.
Many years passed, and the trees grew big and strong, but the day came when it was time for them to be chopped down.
Chop, chop, hack, hack, timber!
In the carpenter shop, the three trees were excited about what they would be made into.
Morning.
What do you have for me today?
Well, the local farmer needs a feed box for his cattle. Will you make one out of this tree for him?
Yeah, that should be fine. I could probably get a dozen or so feed boxes out of this one if you like.
That's great. Thanks.
Oh no! That's not what I wanted to be. I'm too good for an animal feed box. I don't want to be filled with hay for hungry, smelly animals. They make me sneeze. My only dream was to be beautiful, covered with gold and filled with precious treasure and perfume. Now, I will be dirty, smelling like filthy animals instead.
Hello, what can I help you with?
Well, I need you to make a fishing boat for a friend of mine. Do you think this tree will be strong enough?
Of course I was ready. I'm ready for anything. Ready to sail the high seas. Ready for royalty. Ready to sail around the world. But now instead, I'm a fishing boat. This is my worst nightmare. I hate smelly fish. I feel sick.
What about you? What do you want me to do with your tree?
I'm not bothered with what you do with this tree. Don't think this one's worth too much anyway. It's got lots of knots in it and a bit twisted too. Just give me my money and I'll go.
Okay, I'll just leave it as planks in the yard.
Oh no, what happened to my dream? Am I just going to be left here in this pile with no purpose? All I ever wanted was to stay on the mountaintop and point people to heaven. I can't believe this is happening to me.
Time went by, and the three trees forgot their dreams. But one very special night, Golden starlight poured over the first tree as a young woman placed her newborn baby in the manger.
I wish I could have made a cradle for May, but this manger is all there is.
Don't worry, Joseph. This manger is just perfect for God's son.
Wait a minute. Why am I being used for a newborn baby to sleep instead of food for animals? I can't believe this. Something tells me that this baby is very special indeed. I can hear angels singing. I think I'm holding the most treasured baby in history. My dream did come true after all.
Many years later, the little fishing boat was out on a lake filled with smelly fish, when suddenly a violent storm blew up.
Oh no, oh dear, what's happening? I'm not strong enough to withstand the storm. I don't think we'll even make it to the other side of the lake.
Help, help! Jesus, wake up! How can you be asleep in the storm?
Wake up! Do something!
What are they doing? Who is this asleep in my boat? Whatever can he do about it anyway?
Storm! Be quiet. Wind! Stop. Waves! Be still. Peace.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Did you see that? It's a miracle! This Jesus calmed the wind, storm, and the crashing waves with his hands and words. Why would the rain listen to his voice? Maybe I am carrying a king after all, the king of creation. My dream has come true.
Just a year or so after this miracle, one Friday morning, the third tree was startled as the planks were pulled from the pile of the carpenter's workshop. The carpenter nailed together two planks in the shape of a cross. The tree was scared as she was carried roughly through an angry, mocking crowd on a man's shoulder.
Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him! No! What has he done? Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!
Wait! Stop! Save him!
Why are they nailing his hands and his feet to me? Is he a common criminal? Who is this Jesus? I feel so ugly and cruel. What happened to my dream of pointing people to God? But this man, he is not fighting back or saying anything to them. Is he not afraid to die?
At that moment, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, my God, why have you forsaken me? Jesus was thirsty, and there was a vessel full of sour wine. A soldier filled a sponge with sour wine and gave it to Jesus to drink. When Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished. Then the sky turned black as night. Jesus gave up his spirit. But 3 days later, as the sun rose on that Sunday morning, the third tree wondered what was happening as the earth began to tremble beneath her. Then she realized that it was an earthquake and Jesus had burst out of the tomb. He was alive again. Then the third tree knew that God's love had changed everything. It had made the first tree beautiful, the second tree strong, and every time people thought of the third tree, they would think of God and heaven.
Sometimes we may have our own plans and desires, not knowing that God has a perfect plan and purpose for us all along. Just like God had plans for all the details of Jesus' birth, youth, adult lives, and even how Jesus would die, God has a plan for us too. God loves us so much, and we can learn about His plan for us in the Bible. As we reflect on this lovely story of the three trees, let us consider how these encounters with Jesus turn something ordinary into something beautiful, something weak into something strong, and something forgotten into something significant. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Him might be saved. John chapter 3, verses 16 through 17.